Ladies and gentlemen, it's Hanukkah season, which is why we're wearing our Christmas pajamas. And today, we are going to be talking about Buffet's present to the world, this thing. What is it? Well, let me open it up here. Is it a Christmas ornament? Is it something that you dangle off the back of your pickup truck? Is it this? Is it a dog toy?
Could be.
Well, as you can see, it is a clarinet-shaped object with 8 tone holes. It has 7 on the front and 1 on the back. It has no keys, and it is in the key of D. And its range is exactly 9 notes, no more, no less. By the way, I find it fascinating that Buffet designed it so that you can't play any other notes than the ones that it was designed to play, even if you try to change the fingerings. It's just idiot-proof, I guess, which is perfect for me. Anyway, obviously, this is not a D clarinet intended for Strauss. It's geared toward brand new clarinetists, and with that target in mind, I think it's brilliant. So we will review this as a pedagogical tool for teachers who want to start very, very young players on the clarinet. And for that, I have enlisted my wife, Katherine, who has a lot of experience starting very, very young players on the clarinet. Katherine, when you start them, you don't start them on the clarinet. What do you start them on?
If they're 4, we start on the recorder. And once they're ready at 5 or 6, we migrate them to an E-flat clarinet.
So I guess then what's good about the Buffet Pocket Clarinet is that it's as simple as a recorder in terms of it having no keys and it's kid-sized, but I think what is really great is it actually comes with a B-flat clarinet mouthpiece and ligature and reed, so kids can learn how to form an embouchure and make a sound right away. The fingering is super simple too. You add a finger, you get a lower note. You lift a finger, you get a higher note. So no switching with your left middle finger for a C like you would on a recorder or a sax. You just get quarter tones, which I don't know, maybe Stockhausen would write for this. Anyway, so here is the package that you get. You get, this is my mouthpiece, so you don't get that. Sorry. You for about $200, you get this instrument, which comes in 2 parts. It's a wood body and a combination wood and rubber bell. The rubber bell makes a lot of sense. It'll be sitting on a chair. And a lot of the time you don't want to damage the wood, you don't want to damage the chair. I suppose if I were to bap somebody with it, it wouldn't damage them too much. And it comes with a mouthpiece and a ligature. It comes with a buffet reed, a buffet reed.
There's a swab in here.
There's a swab, okay. And this is the fingering chart, the pocket fingering chart for the pocket clarinet. It has a pencil because every musician needs a pencil. And it comes with this sort of nice calzone-shaped nylon case. So that's all the good stuff. Here's what I think Buffet could improve on. They admittedly are not a music publisher, but I think they missed an opportunity here because they don't include any educational materials to get someone started with this instrument. Yes, there is a downloadable PDF that has a fingering chart and a few pieces of music to get started with your pocket clarinet, but it assumes that the person playing it knows how to put on a reed and make a sound, how to read music, what an F4 is, because that's how the fingering chart is notated, and so on. Hell, it assumes that the person knows which hand to put on top. So this is where Katherine comes in. With some cool news about the new Suzuki clarinet method that will be released sometime in the future. Now, Katherine, I am proud. Katherine serves on the international committee developing the Suzuki method for clarinet. So with that, let me ask you a few questions about it, because I think that people who are interested in this instrument may also be interested in the Suzuki clarinet when it comes out eventually. When will it come out? Do you know?
We don't know.
All right, well, since you worked on the Suzuki method, and this seems like a really logical part of something like that, right? Because we started Ariel on Suzuki violin, and her first violin that she came home with looked like it was like maybe a Kleenex box or some kind of box with a ruler on it. Anyway, blah, blah, blah. Did your Suzuki working group have any idea that Buffet was making an instrument like this?
We absolutely did not. One of the biggest issues in developing the method was considering which instrument would most likely be used to teach a student as young as 4 or 5 years old. Would it be an E-flat clarinet, a Dude clarinet, a Clarineo, a Cara clarinet? What exactly would you use with those teeny tiny people?
Well, now that this exists, would your method that you guys have worked on, would it work with this clarinet, the first book, the intro book?
So the order of the tunes in the final cut of our Suzuki Clarinet Method Volume 1 would need some slight rearranging to accommodate the missing A key.
Oh, yeah.
And the later introduction of the register key. So even in book 1, we introduced the register key. But I would absolutely start a very young student with this pocket clarinet, teaching them by ear, and eventually move them to an E flat or bigger clarinet when they're ready.
So would you say then, given your experience, that this is an instrument that you could self-teach yourself on? I mean, I suppose you could self-teach any instrument, but would you say that this instrument is intended for someone who can just kind of pick it up and figure it out using the internet?
I think you'd really need a little bit of instruction, especially as regards the reed, the mouthpiece, assembling it properly, how to form an embouchure, make a sound. After that, you might be able to do a lot more by yourself. And you know, one of my favorite beginning method books is Paula Corley's So You Want to Play the Clarinet, but that's intended for your 17 key, 6-ring clarinet. So some of the tunes in there would work and some of the tunes in there would not work.
Well, speaking of tunes, we have your Suzuki book here, even though it's at the publisher and no one has ever heard anything about it or heard anything from it. Would you be willing to play a tune on this clarinet?
Oh, sure.
Awesome. Let's do that. So now that you've played it, I don't know, what are your impressions of it?
Well, I really like it. I like the wood. I like the sound. You know, it certainly is a lot more pleasant to listen to than a recorder, and a little person anyway. The things that I notice are that these tone holes are rather large for your 5-year-old finger. So I even had a little tricky time with this ring finger on the left hand. But I figured it out. So if this was to become the Suzuki clarinet, kind of like they have Suzuki fractional sized violins, there would need to be a little bit more work done on that to accommodate the itty bitty hands.
That's true.
And I would also really like for B natural to work. I would like for G to be less stuffy.
Okay, fair enough. But it does have a nice sound. It does sound kind of like an E flat clarinet, sort of,
yeah.
Kind of.
Well, it's a clarinet in D.
Do you want to play a duet with me?
Yeah.
Okay. There is a duet that Buffet included as part of that PDF, and it does not mention who wrote it, so I'm just going to assume that Francois Clock, the president of Buffet Crampon USA, wrote it. So thank you, Francois. And let's play that for them.
Okay.
Is there any use for this instrument beyond a beginner learning to make their first sounds in a few simple pieces? Honestly, I don't think so. There really isn't. It serves a really, really specific pedagogical purpose, and I think it does it well. And I think that if Buffet were to have complicated in any other way, like adding an A key or any keys for that matter, I think it would have limited the usefulness of this purpose. It would also have made it more expensive. It would also have made it more prone to maybe breaking. So.
But I know one thing to say about all of this is that when you think about, oh, well, just the first few pieces, when you teach little tiny people, the first few pieces can take a really, really long time. So I think our kids who started violin at 3 or 4 spent basically a whole year on Twinkle. And it's not like she was slow at it. It's just that's how long it took. So this could have a really wonderful niche market for those little 4 and 5-year-olds starting to play.
You know, this is not the only option on the market for this. I mean, we did a review, I think, of the Nuvo Clarineo a few years ago, which is the only thing I think I can compare it to. And comparing this to that, I like this a lot better. First of all, it's wood. Second of all, it uses a real mouthpiece. Like, it's a B-flat clarinet mouthpiece and a B-flat clarinet reed. So it's using the same equipment that ultimately someone would be using on a regular clarinet. So there's no adjusting and then having to readjust when you go to the regular clarinet. It doesn't have any plastic keys that can break. I just think it's a higher quality instrument, and it sounds like a clarinet. I would vote for this over the Clarineo. I don't know what you think.
Yeah, I agree. The one thing that I'd be interested to see is how somebody who's, say, five does with this size of mouthpiece. Like, there is no problem with the E flat, with a good E flat, like a nice Van Doren E flat clarinet mouthpiece, and say a number two reed with 5 year olds. That's not a problem. But this is just enough bigger that I'd have to check it out and try it out on a kid.
Well, there you have it. The Pocket Clarinet from Buffet. It's just under $200. And I think it's a clever business move by Buffet to open up the clarinet to younger students who will likely move up to a Protégé B-flat student clarinet. This actually bears the Protégé brand, so I don't think that's by mistake. So I guess then I would consider the Pocket Clarinet the gateway drug to a life of clarinet addiction. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please put your thoughts in the comments or visit us at earspasm.com to send us a note. And we wish you a happy Christmas Kwanzaa, and
everyone,
we will see you next time. Thanks for watching.